It's being billed as a momentous milestone celebration. David Sarby's 80th birthday. The cake has been frosted, the presents wrapped, and family travel plans are neatly in place. And yet, upon this happy occasion, an unmistakable shroud of mystery has fallen, like a souffle baked at an uneven temperature, or Alabama's hopes of another national championship in football. This should be, by all accounts, and there are plenty of accountants in and around this story, a run-of-the-mill 80th birthday celebration, full of mirth and merrymaking, and a veritable shit ton of Woodford Reserve. The only problem is, David Sarby is not your run-of-the-mill 80-year-old, causing some people to wonder, even those who claim to know him best, if he really has made 80 trips around the sun. Is it possible he could be faking? Certainly his behavior belies his supposed age. In fact, there are almost no outward signs that David Sarby has even come close to reaching maturity, with his beer drinking and lawn bowling. So is David Sarby really just a spry octogenarian celebrating a most monumental birthday? Or perhaps he's a sick, twisted con man, simply trying to get attention and gifts? Or maybe, just maybe, he's both. Tonight on Dateline, the curious case of the 80-year-old stud. Our story begins, allegedly, in Akron, Ohio, of all places, way back in 1940. Akron was known then primarily as the rubber capital of the world, thus a very unlikely place for any baby to be conceived. Yet David Sarby claims to have been born there on January 27th. To further darken the heavy cloud of suspicion hanging over Sarby's early childhood story, there's his very sudden exodus from America's Rust Belt to the sunny shores of Miami, Florida. From burning rubber to rubbing lotion on burning skin. There are, curiously, no official records detailing such a move. A review of ship manifests for the port of Miami at that time shows no indication of such a person coming to Miami at all. So how exactly did David Sarby get all the way from Ohio to Florida? Or did he? David supposedly went on to attend Miami's senior high school. However, a review of the school's yearbooks at the time provide zero evidence of his attendance. Legend has it that the enigmatic young Sarby was a talented bugle player. Is it possible he was too busy playing the bugle? Or spending time with his AZA friends to sit for a school picture? Are we to blindly accept that simple explanation as the reason he cannot be found anywhere in the school annual? Or was something more insidious going on? David Sarby has repeatedly claimed he was part of the 1958 graduating class of Miami Senior High. Why then does no one who attended the graduation ceremony that June remember seeing him in a cap and gown? Is this just a contagious wave of amnesia? Or maybe something more sinister? Dateline has uncovered that a person matching David Sarby's description was enrolled in a high school chemistry class that summer, after graduation had commenced. Very interesting indeed. Even David's own wife, Hetty, casts serious doubt on David's official graduation story.
I first met David Sarby at Miami Senior High in the East Patio, which was called LJ. I was probably 15 or 16, I forget exactly. And it was this summer, or the fall of his, before his senior year.
And he graduated in 1958?
Supposedly.
When our camera stopped rolling, Hetty confided in us that it was possible that David Sarby was actually younger than she. After allegedly graduating high school, Sarby is said to have moved on to the University of Florida in the north-central part of the Sunshine State. However, even this simple fact is very much in doubt. Around the same time, someone matching David Sarby's basic description was seen working as a roofer in the posh neighborhoods of Miami Beach. So, which one was the real David Sarby? Ambitious college student diligently studying his nights away in Gainesville's ivy-clad halls? Or the tan and taut bad boy roofer, toiling under the tropical sun and nailing every shingle in sight?
Oh yes, I remember him. We were living on Star Island at the time and we had the most beautiful manicured lawn, at least it had been. That all changed once that Sarby walked across our lawn with that bull on his shoe. He left footprints all over my yard and then vanished, I tell you. That guy couldn't pour piss out of his boot without the instructions on the heel.
Ultimately, David did materialize at the University of Florida. A fact Dateline was able to verify, talking to a woman who remembers David Sarby for a very unusual encounter they shared.
I remember I had a class in Peabody Hall. I went in one day to use the ladies' room. I don't know why, but I suddenly felt a male presence in there, you know. I just knew he was in there, hiding in one of those stalls. I deliberately made a lot of noise with my heels to scare him away. Honestly, I've always assumed it was a small boy. Why would a grown man hide in the ladies' room?
Could it be that David Sarby was just a boy at the time, masquerading as a college student? That would certainly explain why those who've known him best testify he's never acted his age. It would also go far in explaining David Sarby's habit of telling anyone who will listen about the Florida Gators and their football prowess and so on and so forth. Is this just simple pride in his alma mater, or perhaps a smokescreen, part of an elaborate and lifelong hoax designed to deceive the world about his real age? Listen to what one of his roommates at University of Florida has to say.
So I don't really remember much from that time. We really each had our own activities. We didn't really have any classes together. I think he studied accounting. I was much more into the arts. I did a lot of finger painting and, you know, sculpting with Play-Doh. I was really into like drinking grape juice and, you know, I don't know if he was, but I know I drank a lot of grape juice with him back then. Funny enough, I've seen him since, and we both ended up in the accounting field.
Upon further investigation, Dateline has discovered that this Gator roommate was only 4 years old when she shacked up with Mr. Sarby. Could David Sarby have also been a mere child at the time? After all, a grown man living with a four-year-old girl would have been frowned upon, even in the wild and woolly 1960s. It was also during the 60s that David served his country during the Vietnam War as a member of the armed forces in the United States Coast Guard, where he claims he saw significant action during the Battle of Biscayne Bay. Not surprisingly, Dateline has been unable to find one scintilla of evidence of such a battle. Was it some kind of clandestine mission, a top-secret offensive, or was it something even more offensive? Years later, David would finally lay down his arms and go to work as a mild-mannered CPA for a large international accounting firm. It was during his time as a whiz kid CPA, David developed a reputation for being an avid motorcycle rider. Is this the real reason he moved the family to the canyons of Southern California? And why he would later settle in the rolling hills of Asheville, North Carolina? just a suspiciously quick motorcycle ride from the Blue Ridge Parkway. And what about all that leather? Why would any CPA need so much leather? We decided to interview a few more members of David's family to find out if they ever noticed anything amiss.
I don't really know how old David is. I know that he says he's 80, but I also feel that you can't take everything he says at face value. When I first met him, he said that he and the whole family were Protestant, and I recently found out that that was not true. I'm sorry, I've never really talked about that before. Give me a minute. He also talked a lot about growing a ponytail, and that never happened. So while I know he's a good guy, I feel like maybe you can't believe everything he says.
You know, I really don't know how old my grandpa is. I mean, I know some people are saying 80, but that just doesn't seem right to me. And you know, now that I'm thinking about it, it definitely isn't 80. I have this memory not too long ago where I visited him in North Carolina with one of my friends, and we were all sitting around the dinner table, and he said that he wanted to play his song with my grandma. It was really sweet. He took her hand in his, and all throughout the speakers throughout the house, he played Move Bitch by Ludacris, and you know, that was their song, and I just remember thinking, if that's their song, can't be that much older than me. And I mean, we share clothes. We like the same clothes. We have the same sense of style, so he can't be 80.
I never noticed an age gap, you know, because we enjoyed doing the same sorts of stuff. Playing with Hot Wheels, tickle fights, you know, guy stuff. If anything, I was the more mature one. I mean, you should see the kinds of things that make this guy laugh. Real and mature stuff. I am shocked to find out that he's turning 80. Well, every now and then he did have a little tidbit of wisdom. Like, if you're on a hike, he might tell you, one day this will all be churches and schools. Or say something like, God willing, the creek don't rise. So, I don't know. Maybe he is turning 80.
I just always accepted that he was the age he claimed to be. It really wasn't until pretty recently when, looking back, I began to question things at all. For example, when I was a kid, my friends' dads all had respectable, age-appropriate hobbies. They would spend their weekends working in the garden or golfing. My dad would spend his weekends swilling bourbon and riding a crotch rocket 150 miles an hour. And also, he says fuck a lot.
So here we are at the end of our episode. Another dateline in the can, so to speak. And we like it in the can. Yet we know no more about David Sarby than we did before we started our investigation. Is it possible to ask so many questions and find so few answers? Perhaps that question will also go unanswered. In the end, it's simply time to celebrate David Sarby's 80th birthday. Regardless of the fact that almost no one on planet Earth believes he's really that old. So, let's all say...
Happy birthday, Grandpa!
Happy birthday, David!
Cheers!
Happy 80th birthday, Dad!
Happy birthday, Dad. Cheers.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Grandpa.
Happy birthday, David, and best wishes for many, many, many more birthdays.
David, I want to wish you a very, very happy 80th birthday and many, many, many more. And have a blue one on me.
Happy birthday, Grandpa.
Happy birthday, Mr. Sarby.
And Bob's your uncle.
Bob's your uncle.
Happy birthday, old man. You're older than me.
Hi, this is Steve Spurrier at the University of Florida, and I want to wish happy birthday to David Sarby, number 80. I got that one in a few years coming myself, hopefully. And I know you're a Florida grad. I think you finished up here when I did, back in about 66 or so. So maybe you were there the day I kicked that field goal against Auburn. Probably were. But anyway, yeah, the Gators are doing well. Dan Mullen and his staff, I think, got us heading definitely in the right direction. And maybe some big championship years are coming in the near future. But again, happy birthday. You're a super Gator, David. And I'm just wishing you a happy 80.